In this video, we will analyze how an increase in government spending financed by the central bank or commercial banks can influence the supply of money in an open economy. The first issue to consider is to understand why the government will borrow money in the first place. If their tax revenue is less than the level of government expenditure for the year, they will be running a budget deficit. A budget deficit can be financed through borrowing. In this video, we'll focus on how borrowing from the central bank and commercial banks can impact the money supply. First, we'll look at what happens when the government borrows from the country's central bank. When the government borrows from the central bank, it creates a debt to the central bank. The government then takes money out of the central bank that it introduces into circulation. Once the government spends this newly borrowed money, it will eventually end up as deposits for commercial banks, and the credit creation process mentioned in the previous video will take effect. To understand why, let's take a look at a simple worked example. Say the current money supply is $10,000. The government borrows $100 from the central bank. Assume the liquidity ratio is 10%, therefore the credit multiplier is equal to 10. The $100 borrowed from the central bank multiplied by 10 means the ultimate increase in the money supply is $1,000. The new level of the money supply is the original $10,000 plus the newly created $1,000, which brings the total to $11,000. The government could also finance their deficit by borrowing from commercial banks. This process would also cause an increase in the money supply, and let's look at why. If the government borrows from commercial banks by issuing short-term securities, the security can serve as a cash asset against which the commercial bank can make additional loans. As a result, the government gets a loan and issues a security to the lending bank. The security can be used as an asset equivalent to cash against which further loans can be generated. Let's look at this another way. When Commercial Bank A makes a loan of $9,000 to a private business or individual, it still counts as an asset. If the bank is maintaining a liquidity ratio of 10%, then it must hold on to the $1,000 in reserves and cannot loan it. However, since they have loaned out $9,000, they are unable to make further loans. Let's compare this to what happens when a commercial bank makes a loan to the government. Commercial Bank B makes a loan to the government of $9,000. The government issues the bank a short-term security. If the bank is maintaining a 10% liquidity ratio, then it cannot loan the $1,000 in reserves. However, due to the fact that they have a security with a value of $9,000, the bank can continue to make loans of up to $9,000. So now the bank has a loan out to the government for which it will receive interest and can continue to make additional loans up to the value of the government security. In both banks A and B, loans are issued. However, the situation in Bank B allows the bank to continue to issue loans and as such will result in a greater increase in the money supply. By now, you should have a better understanding of how an increase in government spending financed by either the central bank or commercial banks can influence the supply of money in an economy. If you have any questions or comments, post them below and we can try to answer them together. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.